fourth pillar of calculus is the whole is the sum of the parts. If you are given a problem that's complicated, where you have to find some bulk quantity, like let's suppose you're trying to find the area under a curve between A and B. And again, you remember the picture's worth a thousand words. Areas under curve represent lots of real world quantities. If you wanted to do that, well, unless the function is really simple, like unless the function is a constant, you don't have an out-of-the-box formula that'll just tell you exactly what to do. Instead, what you do is you take this big bulk quantity and you cut it into little pieces that you understand a lot better. So what we've just done is we've said we have some region and we have the total area equals the sum of the areas of the different little strips. And each strip, I'm going to use the Greek letter for sum. Each strip is basically a rectangle. Okay, it's not exactly a rectangle. The top is wiggling a little bit, but it's basically the width times the height. And we call the width delta x, and actually I'm going to put it on the right, and the height is the value of the function. And you've got n strips, and that's a good approximation. Now, what do you do with approximation? Well, close is good enough. You take the approximation and you make it better. How can we make it better? We chop it up even finer. How do you make it better still? You chop it up even finer. So if you want the exact area, that's the limit as you chop things up finer and finer and finer of the sum as I goes sum over all n strips. And for each strip, you take the value of the function times the width of the strip. And we give this a name. We call this an integral. Call this the integral from a to b of f of x dx. The very word integral means whole. You have, a building has structural integrity if it's one piece and isn't falling apart. You have personal integrity if you don't speak with a forked tongue. An integer is a whole number. An integral is a whole quantity that you make out of the little pieces. Now, it's not just areas. If I gave you a rod, and we take this rod and we're going to rotate it around the origin. And we want to figure out what's the moment of inertia. Well, that looks like a complicated problem. So instead, you break the rod into a bunch of little pieces. And you say, the total moment of inertia is the sum of the moment of inertia of each piece. And then you have to figure out what the moment of inertia is of each piece. Well, you have to figure out what is the mass of each piece and multiply it by the distance squared, and you get the moment of inertia of each piece. If I gave you some region, like suppose you had a pyramid. You have a pyramid and you want to know what the volume of that pyramid is. Well, could be a complicated problem. But if you slice the pyramid into a bunch of slices, then the volume of each then the total volume is the sum of the volume of each slab. And what's the volume of the slab? The volume of each slab is the area of the slab times the thickness. So it's the same idea. You have some thickness, you have some area, you add them up, you take a limit. Now, the procedure for taking a limit, okay, this can be complicated. But the idea of a limit should be what comes in mind whenever you do integrals. The same goes in higher dimensions. If you've got a population of a certain region, you might want to chop it up into a bunch of strips. And then you might want to chop each of those strips into a bunch of little rectangles. You figure out the contribution of each rectangle, you add them up, you get the whole. That's the idea in all of integration. Break things up into little pieces that you can understand, add up the little pieces, and take a limit as you chop finer and finer and finer.